Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop Elements video, I'll be talking about layers for beginners. Now, this video is for people who are brand new to Photoshop Elements, and the reason why I'm doing this is I get these kind of questions. People are very confused about layers when they're first starting out with Photoshop Elements. And if you've watched any of my videos, you'll see that layers are vitally important for doing most of my projects. So this is to get everybody up to speed so you know how to use layers to make it much easier to work with my video projects. Okay, let's get to it. We'll start off with the very basics right now, and that's that this thing over here on the right hand side, this is your layers panel. And you'll see that right down at the bottom down here where it says layers, that's the button to show and hide that layers panel right there. If you don't see that, you can also go up to the window menu and come down here. There's layers, just click on that or hit the F11 key. All of those will bring up the layers panel. Now, normally I have my layers panel running all the time. Two more things when you're working with my projects, I do all of my projects in the expert mode up here. So not in the quick mode, not in guided, but in the expert mode. And also I normally have my program set up to open up floating windows. Let me show you that very quickly as well. Go up to the edit menu, come down to preferences right down there at the bottom of that. Go over here to general, click on that, and here's the little preferences dialog box. And you want to take a look right down here where it says allow floating documents in expert mode. Make sure that's checked. Also make sure that enable floating document window docking is checked as well. Make sure those two are checked. Once you have that done, then all the basics are set. What that allows you to do is to pull your tab down like this and float your window, or go back up here. Notice that kind of goes transparent. Let go, it docks it again. This is also very useful when you're moving images from one file to another. We'll be looking at that as well. Okay, so that's the basics of where the layers panel is, how to open it up, and also my two basic settings. That's that expert tab right there, and of course the floating documents. Let's now open up two files. Go to File, New, and let's do a blank file. I'll leave mine at the standard default Photoshop Elements size. And there we go, that's a floating window. Comes in as a floating window right there. Let's open up one more. I'll do File and Open. And I'll just grab something off of here. This is a bunch of stuff I've done in previous discussions here, previous projects. I'll just grab one of these. Here's a recent one that I did. I'll use this one. Bring that open. And there we go. Now, when you bring in a new image like this, just opening up the file, it comes in as one layer in the Layers panel, and it says Background. This is a little lock over here. This shows that the transparency is locked. There's no transparency in here, so you really can kind of ignore that. It's a special layer that's always on the bottom of your layer stack if you're working with that. It most of the time only comes in handy if you're changing the background using the graphics down here, which I've done on a few of my videos. But in most cases, that's what you get. Let's look at the blank file. Notice it's the same basic thing. It says background right there. There's your lock and there's your background. So it's really the same thing, either with an image or with a new file. They're both opened up like that. Aside from that, there is no difference between a new file and an image. It's just that this has a picture in it and this doesn't. Okay, let's close that down. Now, normally when I'm working with an image, like in here, I don't want to be doing any changes on the background layer. This is just a safety precaution. And an easy way to do that is to go up here. Notice we have a bunch of buttons up here. The one you care about the most is that one right there, and that's create a new layer. If you just click on that, you get a new blank layer above whatever layer you were just on. There's our blank layer. That little kind of checkerboard pattern, that means that this is transparent. So I can actually see through this layer down to the layer underneath. If you want to get rid of a layer, just hit the trash can over there. It'll ask you to confirm that, and that goes away. If you want to copy a layer, just take that layer and drag it up to that same button, and it gives you a copy. I do this all the time. I'll then hide that. I can now do whatever I want on this copy of the background, and I'll never touch my original. So if I make a mess and ruin it up here, I can always go back and make another copy from the background. That's why I use this as a safety. Very, very good habit to be in. Let me now show you the two main reasons why I like having floating document windows. One is I can pull it up like this, grab my corner and make the window much larger, and then use my zoom tool over here and just zoom in and get a much bigger image to work on. I can still move it around. I can kind of, you know, pull that up. I can still get to all of my options down here, my tools over there, but I can get a real close, real nice, large image. That's one of the main reasons I like using these floating windows. The other reason, let me just put this back to a smaller size. Here's our zoom control right there. Let's bring it down a bit. There we are, and I'll squeeze this back down. Other reason I like using floating windows is that I can take this layer over here. Notice that it has kind of a dark background. That's the one we're currently on. That's this layer here. I can take this and just drag it over to this file, and it copies that layer from here over to that file. I'm just going to hide this one. I'll click on that little minimize button and hide that. If you want to see it again, just go to the photo bin, and it's right there in the photo bin. Go back to our tool options. I also normally switch over here to my basic move tool. Just out of habit, I always go back to that tool. Now, once we have it here, notice that this is underneath all of these layers in here. Each one of these layers is one of the letters right in there. The very top here, that's the four beginners. That's that bit right there. Now, if I am on this layer that's selected, I can move that object around. In this case, that's that picture. So you can move around the contents of a layer independently of any other layers. This is the main reason why you want to be working with layers, is that you can work on the layers independently of each other, and that gives you all kinds of power when you're working in this program. Lots of stuff you can do with that. And it's a major technique here for working with your different projects. Now you can change the order in here of your layers. Notice also, layers for beginners, that's right here, says for beginners. It's actually in front of everything else. What's on top is also in front. I can show that. I'll go here where it says for beginners, and I'll drag that up here on top. You can see there it is. It's in front of everything else. So what's on top is in front. See here, the L is in front of the A, which is just beneath it. The A is above the Y, and it's in front of the Y. The Y is above the E, and it's in front of the E. So the stacking here is things in front down to things in behind, and then your background. You can change the order just by taking a layer. You can actually drag it up and down. Notice that kind of a dark line that goes in there? That shows you where it's going to go once you let go. I let go right here. It moves up to that point. It's now in front of all those letters, but it's in behind the L, and it's in behind for beginners. So you can change the stacking order here very easily. Something else that you can do is you can show and hide layers. That's this bit right there, little eye. Click on that, and it hides it. Click on that again, and it shows you. So you can hide and show layers. This allows you to have several different layers that you'll be using for different parts of a project, or possibly that you are going to be using for different versions of the project. Just show and hide those. There you go. Something else you can do, I'm just going to pull this down to the bottom again. Something else you can do if you're working in Photoshop Elements 15 or later, 15 or 2018 or 2019, and that's this button right there. This is a layer group. Click on that, you get a new group. There it is. I'll drag that to the top. And you can then put things inside of that group. I'm going to click on the top layer here, and I'm going to hold the shift key down and click on the bottom of my letters. So you can select more than one layer at a time. Click on one, click on the second one, holding down the shift key. I'll then pull all those and put them on top of that group layer, and it puts them inside the group. Notice here that they're now kind of moved in just a little bit. They're indented. That shows that they are inside of the group. Now where this is useful is two main things. I can show or hide what's in that group. Little arrow right there, click on that. It shows it, click it again, it hides it. So it's a real help to organize everything in here. Also, there's a little eye here. I can show or hide everything in that group with just that one click. There's a lot more you can do with groups as well, but that's good enough for right now for our basic discussion. Let's just go ahead, we'll collapse that and hide that. And there are just two more things I want to talk about here about layers just for beginners. Everything else I cover in my other videos. If I'm doing a video, I do a different technique. I'll show you that technique in the video, but you'll understand that once you understand all of this stuff. The first one is how to change your background. I'm going to hide this layer right here. Let's just hide that one. And I'll change this background in here. You can do anything you want to. You can paint in here if you want to. You can add a pattern in here if you want to. And the fun thing to do is go down here to the button that says graphics. Click on that. It brings up your graphics. And at this little drop down here, change that to backgrounds. And then we get all kinds of backgrounds in here you can use to put on that background layer. Let me just choose this one right there. Click on it, and there's that background. If we go back to the layers, you'll see how that now fills that background layer. If I go back to graphics again, let's change to something else. Let me just grab this one right here. It changes to this one. If I go back to layers, it has now changed that layer. Now there is a way, if you want to have more than one background, you can switch back and forth between without going to graphics. It's easy to do. Just take this background layer, drag it up to the new layer button right there. Gives you a copy of the background. Notice how the actual background layer is italicized and this one is not italicized. The background layer also is always at the bottom. It's always your bottom one. It won't be anyplace else. It's always at the very bottom. So let's hide that copy. Let's go back to graphics. Go back to this one. Just one click. There it is. Back to our layers. And there's that new background. I can now switch back and forth real fast just by showing and hiding this second layer. Okay, that's the first way to come in and work with your backgrounds. The other thing is bringing in images into your project. Now, we already copied over. Let me show you that one more time. That's the easiest way to bring a layer or a new layer into a project. Go up here to File. Actually, it's still open, isn't it? Okay, let's go down to Photo Bin. It's right there. Just take the layer you want. And this is, again, where floating windows really helps. Just grab that layer, drag it over here, let go, and it makes a copy, and it comes in as a new layer right there. The reason it says background copy is because that's what it was called in the other file right here, background copy. You can rename those, just double click on the name and type in a new name if you want to. Okay, the second way to bring a new layer in, new image, just hide that one. Let's go back to that file again. There it is. I'm going to go up here to Select and All, or the Control A keyboard shortcut. That little marching ants, but this means that this is now selected. I can then go up here to Edit and Copy. There you go. Let's just hide that again. We're back over in here, and then Edit, Paste, and it pastes that in as a new layer. This time it comes in as Layer 1. That's just the name that it gives it. It's the exact same thing as this one down here. It's just a different name because we pasted it in. It gives it in as a new layer. So that's your second way of bringing an image onto your layers. Let me show you the last way, and that's to place an image. Now let's go up here to File, come down to Place right there. Simply find your image. There it is. I'll click on that one. Choose Place, and it places that image into your file again. Notice how it comes back in as a new layer right there. Notice that this time it has the name of the file as the name of the layer. When it's in place, just click on that green check mark. There you go. That's our third way to bring images into a new project. Again, there's a lot more I can do with layers, and in all of my projects, if I do different layer things, I'll show you those steps in the projects. So there you go. That's all the basics of how to work with the different layers inside of Photoshop Elements. Again, real basics up here. You can show or hide layers right there. You can rearrange layers just by clicking on one and dragging it. I just put that in behind the A. So you can drag up and down. You can put them into groups if you have Elements 15 or later. You can show or hide layers down here. You can bring layers in by dragging and dropping. You can bring them in by copying and pasting, or you can bring them in by using the place command right there. And again, everything else you'll see in all of my other project videos. So there you go. That's how to work with layers, and that's a good basic beginning for working with the most important aspect of Photoshop Elements, which is understanding how the layers work. And last thing, if you found this video useful, make sure you click that like button and also share with your friends. Just click on the share button and share away. If you haven't already done so, also make sure that you subscribe to my channel. And if you really want to learn how to use Photoshop Elements, the best way to do that is with my training course. And there's a link for that right down there in the description. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.